So this is my 1977 swing bike. I've had this for about 20 years now. It's pretty easy to Google the background. One of the Osmonds. I think they were kind of the first kind of famous people to ride this bike. I have some riding footage from, it's got to be 15 years ago at a Volkswagen show that I was at, that I'll provide a link to at some point in the description. Pretty rare bike, pretty hard to ride. I think a lot of people have trouble dealing with these when you unlock the rear end, which I'll get to in a moment here. This bike is completely stock, meaning, except for, I think I've replaced the inner tubes, but other than that, the grips, tires, all the stuff that normally perishes on this bike is still original. I haven't cleaned it up or anything, so it's got, you know, the patina from many, many years of even being stored in a garage in a fairly dry area. So the interesting thing about this is that you can steer the rear end. Right now it's locked, but you can steer the rear end and you know, take sharp corners or just ride the bike pretty funky manner. You can unlock it and you can then get the rear end to swing and just allow a completely different dynamic than what most people are used to. The springs are set up on here. It's pretty hard to ride without the springs. You see that it's got three different anchor points to allow you to adjust the amount of tension on it, which then allows you to adjust the, or that changes the amount of self-centering you get with the rear wheel. Coaster brake with the caliper in the front, original saddle. Strangely, a raccoon got in my garage, and as I was trying to chase out, it climbed over my collection and cut the saddle, which is unfortunate. Originally sold at Ace Cycle. I have a couple bikes from Ace's shop. Lorne Atkinson, who's a former Canadian Olympian, he started that shop, and unfortunately it closed down, I believe, October of 2018, after pretty close to or around 50 years in business. Talked to his grandson the day, or about a month before they closed down, and I tried to make it by, but it didn't. Interesting sticker you don't see anymore. This is made in Taiwan, ROC, Republic of China. All the friction going on right now, it's kind of interesting to see that. Same as working on a German bike I showed, or that my GTI, where it still has you know, manufactured in West Germany and such. It's a 16-inch front wheel, caliper brake on the front, and there's a bit more of a close-up of the head tube badge and some of the corrosion that's happening underneath the paint there, just to focus a bit. So, yeah, these are lots of fun to ride. There are companies that make, like, mountain bike or kind of modern versions of these. I have a parrot, unfortunately, decided to eat that grip and part of the cable housing too, I believe. That's kind of unfortunate, but you don't see a lot of these around. I believe they made them in yellow, green, orange, and blue. I'm sure some people have all four of the colors. I don't. I just have this one. Definitely gets a lot of attention when you're riding. In my case, I live just outside of Vancouver, so I've got the seawall nearby, and yeah, it's pretty funky. It's pretty fun. If you're already have, definitely don't get one of these as your sole bike, but your only bike. But if you are interested, check out the various incarnations of these as, like I said, mountain bikes and such. And if you don't already have good balance, you're either going to develop good balance trying to ride something like this, or you're going to end up wiping out a lot. Anyways, there's not much to say about it. It's, you know, high tensile steel. It's not, you know, a fantastically constructed frame. Yeah. Anyways, I'm looking forward to the weather getting a bit better, and hopefully I can take this out. And, you know, it tends to, like I said, attract a bit of attention, so you can kind of educate people on, you know, what these things are all about, if they're curious. I tend to get approached a lot, so. Anyways, I don't have much more to say. It's got, like I said, the natural kind of patina. I haven't cleaned it up or anything, so. Yeah, anyways, thanks for watching. Bye for now.